Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Always great to get off to a good start in conference play. Time for some early season action in the ACC. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Jordan takes it right side. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down around the 23-yard line.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards. That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
From their own 44-yard line, first down. He makes it to the 45-yard line. He keeps it and picks up maybe a yard.
And that was the sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
The stop at the 43.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. He's under pressure. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled at the 46-yard line. They get 3 yards on the play.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. Got the corner. He fields the punt at the 13. They'll bring him down at the 25. Miami's staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk, and I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons, and I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
From their own 29-yard line, Second down. Nice run there. The halfback picks up maybe 5 yards on the draw play. That'll make it third and one. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on him. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And down he goes at about the 45.
Man, that is a great call and a big gain, especially on an early down.
Rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
You know, Brad, the defensive coordinator does a nice job with the coverage call here. Everybody's in position to be able to make the play. The only problem is they didn't intercept the football. That's something that they got to be happy with the coverage, but not happy with the result.
Short pass, middle of the field. He's tackled at the 42-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35. Made at the 12.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
From the 12-yard line, it's first down. He scrambled. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He makes the PAT. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The Aztecs were ranked 24th. Now the loss is likely to knock them out of the polls. And for Army, they've won 2 straight. Army gets the win by 4. And for Rodgers, he finishes the game with a handful of touchdowns, 5 of them on the day. After this performance, only one way to describe him. Flat boy dog warrior. The Bulldogs pull it out by a field goal.
Wow, you can feel the shockwave caused by that upset all the way to our game. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The Hurricanes are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 25. Makes it to the 34.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. It's second and 10. Ball on the 34. I'm coming after you, 25. Run, 395. stop behind the line.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From their own 30-yard line, third down. Goes left and tackled in a hurry.
No gain on the play. That'll make it fourth and 14.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. Tackle made at the 42.
Really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Miami is up by a touchdown. And he's tackled right away. And that'll be a first down on the 6-yard pass.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap and he threw it right out there. Fires it out. Brought down right around the 12-yard line.
That's good for the game, 34 yards. First down.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Throwing left, finds his receiver, touchdown. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a four-play, 58-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So the score now, 14-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he just got drilled. The Hurricanes are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down like this.
They go to the ground game. Nice run to the outside.
Second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 27-yard line. Heading for the corner. And he's taken down at about the 29-yard line.
2 yards. That makes it third and three.
There are 3 quarters remaining. The Hurricanes lead it by 2 touchdowns. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. under pressure. He gets sacked on the play.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. Jackson is back awaiting the punt. Booming kick. Looking for the corner, and he's taken down at the 44. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's in trouble. He's scrambling. He's hit and got away. Quick out to his receiver. Knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line. First down. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Got him on the screen play. He's taken down around the 12-yard line.
No gain. That brings up second and 9.
Him down in the backfield. We've got third and 12. Ball on the 14. Under heavy pressure. And they got him. And the linebacker gets in there for the sack.
Great time to bring some heat from the linebacker spot.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. It's up. And he missed it left. No good. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They'll get him for a loss. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone buy him that time.
And the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on their own 23. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. Receiver.
Very stern effort there by the defense. They weren't giving up anything on that series.
And they're coming after this punter. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. Johnson's reputation really precedes him when you talk about how he can lead a team, but when you see him in person, you really feel it, Kirk.
It's a different, completely different feel when you watch him in person, and it has a lot to do with the intangibles that he brings to the table. I mean, there's examples here in his first half where he's been able to help his team, not just being able to throw the football or make good decisions, but just helping guys get back into the huddle, kind of patting guys on the back, trying to get this offense to believe in themselves and almost just willing this team to a victory. And so far, he's done all those things.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle right around the 48-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you.
Hey, Mike 34. Yeah, Black 80.
And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Quick throw to the tight end. And they make the stop at the 36.
First down.
From the 36-yard line, first down.
Woo-hoo! 24 is the mic.
They'll bring him down around the 41-yard line.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
Back and he's going to lose yardage. How about the play of this defensive end?
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Loose football recovered by the defense. Couldn't have asked for a better time for the turnover, right, Herbie?
Well, I'm sure they could have used a couple of these earlier in the game, but better late than never.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. So the call on the field will be reversed. Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Got a first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Ready, fire,
now he tries to buy some time. They bring him down.
Call it a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Thrown. I don't think he got anything on that. It's third down, 8 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete. Jackson, the return man. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Miami's offense really had a going in that first quarter, but they're starting to struggle here in the second hurry.
Well, because they played so well early in this game, even though they have been struggling, they still have a pretty comfortable lead. Now let's see if they can hold on to it here as we get ready for the second half.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Pass complete and taken down immediately.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. Throwing right.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
They shut that drive down pretty emphatically. That's something to build on.
Louisville just took their first time out. Franklin is the deep man awaiting the return. And he's hammered down.
I got to give this defense credit, Kirk.
Brad, I don't know what the heck's going on with this offense. They just haven't been able to come away with anything.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. He's on the run. Tries to get around the corner. He's at midfield. And down he goes at the 38.
He started to run and saw that the field ahead of him was wide open. That's a huge play.
From the 38-yard line, it's first down. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
Man left, man left. Four down. 25, check 25.
Ready.
Mike.
He scrambled. And he shoved out of bounds at the 24-yard line. A minute left in the half.
Ready.
Looking for his man, incomplete.
Pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
We've got third and 10. Ball on 24. And he's tackled at the 18.
That makes it fourth and 4.
Strike to the back, no good. Huge play for the defense. The last time this offense had the ball, it was 3 and out.
Mike 34, 2, 2, 2.
makes his way to about the 28. So at the end of the half, the Hurricanes in front, 14-0.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
That's going to do it at halftime, just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He'll return it from the three. Across the 30. And down he goes at the 33. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Up the middle for a nice gain. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on their own 37. He's under pressure. Here's a quick throw. And that one's fallen incomplete.
Number 7, the intended receiver on the way. That makes it 37.
Over the middle to his tailback. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Kane, staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
And they'll bring him down behind the line.
Loss of 4 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13. Ball on the 29.
My game. Let's go.
Tackle made at the 40.
That's good for a game. That makes it third and 3.
Complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, Mike A.
tackle after positive yardage. From their own 48-yard line, second down. Scrambling, brought down at the 49-yard line. Conley only gets about a yard there on the quarterback scramble. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. Jackson will be the return man. Gets it away. Wait a minute, he's going to throw. Oh, man, he took him down hard. Here's the eighth play of the series. Out to around the 35. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Play action here. He's going to scramble, and he's taken down at about the 27-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. And they get nice yardage on that run. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They've been stopped short down here the last two trips. He's scrambling. Tackle at the 17-yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. Jordan picks up 5 with the carry.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 12-yard line, second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Here's play number 14 of this drive. Gives it to the back, and they make the stop at the 4-yard line, and he gets a yard on the run.
That brings up 2nd and goal.
That brings up a 2nd and goal. Ball on the 4. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Hands it to the back. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
Well, these guys won't give up. That 14-point deficit this offense was facing a minute ago can disappear really fast, especially with all the time left in this game.
He makes the PAT. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the two. He's to the 20. The Hurricanes fans have got to be going crazy. It looked like they had this one in hand or could put it out of reach, and they haven't been able to do it.
It's a tough game for the fans to watch because their team was so dominant early in the game, and now they've just gone cold, and they've allowed the opponent to get right back into this game. They better find something here to be able to try to get out of here with a win.
He lets it go. Incomplete pass.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Miami is up 7. Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down around the 25-yard line. With a sack, they get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Walker is the punter. He's tackled at the 40-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
He fights forward to about the 40. From the 40-yard line, it's second down.
Fight eight.
And he has it on the corner. And down he goes, right around the 40.
No gain on the play. That brings up third and 10.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30.
Four down. My game. Ready.
He's hit and taken down. There's a strike complete. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
So with one quarter remaining, Miami in front, 14-7. We're just about set to start action here again
Mike
in the fourth
eight.
Quarter. Fires it out. And he's tackled right around the 12-yard line. From the 12-yard line, first down.
My game. Set, 390, check. Spider.
Scrambling around, heading for the corner. He's tackled at the 9.
Makes the tackle. Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Two times.
Four down. Mike eight. Ready.
Here's a counter, losing yards.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker, and he got through almost untouched.
Third and long here with a vital drive in the fourth quarter, and they need a conversion.
Set, green 88.
they did a good job of reading the play and positioning themselves well to break up the pass.
That brings us fourth and 11.
He gets it up, and he's got it. Turner looks ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 25. This is a pretty crucial series right here with things being so tight. Your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Miami is up by four. Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle made right around the 48-yard line.
Gain of 27 on the play. First down.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. Throws a strike over the middle. Brought down at the 35-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Tackled after decent pickup.
That's a gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He makes his way out to about the 12.
That's a gain of 17 on the play. First down.
Hit immediately. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Defense stacked in tight here. It's a fumble, and they fall on the loose ball.
Anytime a running back loses the football, it puts a little bit more caution in his step. You'll see them covering the ball with two hands, and it sometimes can slow him down.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Miami holds a four-point lead. They bring him down in the backfield. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. carries to the 20. And he just got drilled. Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
Well, you work on the two-minute offense literally 12 months out of the year for these kind of opportunities. Well, here it is in front of you. It's a one-possession game, over 2 minutes to go in the game. What are you going to do about it?
He's taken down around the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line. First down.
Ready! Lighting!
He gets to about the 41-yard line. Run and he's brought down. Jordan gains about 5 yards on the run.
That brings him second and five.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Off play action. Now he's on the move. And he's taken down at about the 29-yard line. To the run game, and this time he's met immediately.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Gains his way to the 19-yard line.
Gain of 12 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, Mike eight. Mike eight.
Set.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. This is the eighth play of this drive. Get the call again. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Well, this is it. They've got all four downs to get in the end zone. To the end zone. Intercepted. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
There's a fumble. Defense has it. It's one of the corners. To the 20. Gains his way to the 7-yard line. And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
Giving the ball away can rattle your confidence, but he just needs to relax and not try to force it. He's starting off in great field position now.
They'll get him for a loss.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That brings him second and goal.
They're at the 8. Second down. A little over a minute in the game. And he's leveled at the 12-yard line.
Call it a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it 30 to goal.
Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
From the 17-yard line, third down.
Let's go!
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And he is drilled at the 16-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
This is it. They've got to get it in the end zone. And he's immediately tackled. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. 6 yards there on the option keeper. Louisville will have one timeout remaining. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And that's a first down.
First down, and now they have an opportunity to run some more time off the clock.
Two ties.
Three down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Miami is up by a touchdown. He'll go down to one knee. Scoring points was a special occasion on this day. It's final. 17-10, Hurricane. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports, Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.